I've never heard of the clock.
You should go down at 12.
I take this late.
Hold. Take my sword. There's a husbandry in the heaven. Their candles are all out. Take me that too. A heavy summons lies like lead upon me, and I shall not sleep. Merciful powers restrain in me cursed thoughts that gives way to your repose. Give me my sword. Who's there?
Window breaks. Which is the east end? and Juliet is the sun. Oh, arise, fair sun, and kill me in these moons, already sick and pale with grief, that thou art her maid, art far more fair than she. Be not her maid, since she is envious. Her vestal livery is still but sick and green, and none but fools do wear it. Cast it off. Oh, it is my lady! Oh, it is my love! Not that she knew she were! She speaks yet. She says nothing. What of that? Her eye discourses. I will answer it. She is not to me, she speaks. Two of the fairest stars in all of the heaven, having some business, do entreat her eyes to twinkle in their spheres as they should come. What if her eyes were there? Lay her head. The brightness of her cheek would shade those stars as daylight doth a lamp, and birds would sing and think it were not night. See how she leans that hand upon that cheek, that I were a glove upon that hand, that I might touch that cheek. Speaks! Oh, speak again, bright angel, for thou art as glorious to this night, being over my head as a winged messenger of heaven, under the wandering eyes of mortals who fall back to gaze on him, when he strides the lazy, pacing clouds and sails across the bosom of the air.